Hey guys, in this video you're gonna learn how to use the new window function that Qlik has just released. It's important to mention that this function is only available on Qlik Cloud, and maybe it will be available on Qlik Enterprise by late November. So let's start. Well guys, for starters, I have loaded sample data here just so we can understand it properly what the window function does. So for us to use the window function, the table needs to be already loaded on the script. So like here, I have already created a loading line here, and I'm gonna use a preceding load and type the window function. So the syntax of the window function is very simple. We use the window right here, and then we make a calculation. We can do a min, max, average, or sum. Let's take the average of our salary field right here. Okay, and you want to know the average salaries by departments. So we get comma right here and department as average salary. And guys, this is going to create a new field on our data model. For each row, we'll take the average salary of each department. So let's run this and see what happens. Okay, so I have my table right here, and let's take the average salary that we just had, and let's see what happens. Well, so it's very interesting, because here we have separated by department. So let's take IT department first. So the average salary of the IT department is 60K. So for each row of employees who are in the IT department, it will create a new column with this value. So in this case, we can compare the current salary of the employee of Dave right here to the average salary of the department. That's very interesting, because for us to use that before, we would need an aggregation function. And the aggregation function is very heavy on the front-end side. It can cause some delays on the graphs and charts, you know. Well, you can also have multiple fields besides just one. Like right here, we are only using department. But what if, for example, we want to aggregate our data by country as well? We have so the country field right here. So we will aggregate our data by department and country at the same time. And we just need to type comma and country right here. So let's do this by the average salary, for example. And let's see what happens. Okay. So guys, this is very interesting, because now the results change a lot on the average salary field right here. So let's take the HR department, for example, and let's see what happens to it. So we have one combination for HR and the country USA. So the average salary will be the same, you know. The same thing here for HR and Brazil, for example. We have 55K. So let's see other examples, all right? So here on the IT department, things change a little bit, because we have two guys here in Brazil, and they're from IT department, and one guy from the USA. So the average salary row will be based only on those two rows right here, because there are only two rows with those two combinations. So 60K and 62K, the average is 61K, all right? And the same thing with the department field. So the fields that have multiple combinations, like those two right here, we will get the average of the salaries for each one of them. And marketing and Brazil right here will get the same value. Well, guys, we can also use other operations like sum, min, max, or median, for example, to have the same result in the script. So the syntax is the same. We just need to change the operation right here. So I put some new operations right here, and let's load the data and add our new fields. So now we have the max of salaries by department, the median of salaries, the min of salaries, and the sum of salaries by department. So guys, this is very interesting, because this opens so much possibilities, you know, that we can do on the script. Another option that we can have here is actually to add a filter to one of those fields. So let's take country here for example and filter only data from the USA. So equals USA. That's simple, guys. So let's run the script and see what happens. Okay, so right here now, we only get the fields in the average salary field by the country USA. So we don't have fields in Brazil anymore. So this is a very nice addition, and depending on your requirements, it could come very handy. If you want more information about the window function, the click help got you. So right here on this page, we can know more things about the window function, some examples that we have done on this tutorial, and some other cool stuff that you can do. And also in the end, there is a limitations tab of what the window function cannot do or some warnings. I will leave the link right here on the description, so definitely check it out. Well guys, did you like the window function? I certainly did, because this opens so many possibilities and some improvements that we can make on our ClickSense apps. So leave me a like, subscribe to the channel if you're not, and I'll be seeing you on the next video. Zaparoli, out!